from Tamworth, the country music capital of Australia, Harry Ann Miller's CompuTicket is proud to present the Whittle Family Singers and Travelling Rodeo Orchestra. Would you put your hands together and give a warm Fitzroy welcome to the King of Australian country music, the farmer's friend and independent candidate in the next federal election, Mr. Slim Whittle!
Hello, I'm Slim Whittle, and you're the best audience I've ever had.
We got married in a fever, hotter than a pepper sprout. We've been talking about Tamworth ever since the fire went out.
Yeah, I'm going to Tamworth. I'm going to mess around. Yeah, I'm going to Tamworth.
People gonna stoop and bow. All them women gonna make me teach them what they don't know how. Yeah, I'm going to Tamworth. I'm gonna loosen my coat. Yeah, I'm going to Tamworth.
So much. Who loves country music? Fabulous. Because we got a whole bunch of songs just as good as that one. Woo! How about a big hand for my beautiful wife, Miss Tammy Whittle?
Thank you.
Come on up here, kids. Our son, Whit Whittle, we were very lucky to have him get some leave from the Air Force. Also over here is our beautiful daughter, Acacia Whittle. We've got great hopes that this year Acacia will be voted Miss Forequarter at the Tamworth Beef
That's
Festival.
Right. Last year I got voted Best and Fairest by the Tamworth Footy Club.
So we've got our fingers crossed this year. Look at these teeth. Where have you seen a set of teeth like them before, eh?
On the drums over there is my brother Jack.
Thanks a lot, Slim. Good evening, everybody. It is a pleasure to be back here on the Amateur Hour with you again, Slim. I must say, Slim, too, that I'm very proud to be here tonight and to be associated with your campaign to get into the Senate, mate. The people of this country are waking up that Australia rides on the back of the cow's hoof, Slim.
No.
And I just want to say that you're the bloke that can put this country back on its feet again with your beef politics, mate. No worries at all. No worries.
Oh, really? Thank you. My brother, Jack Whittle.
Thanks very much. Thanks a lot.
Thank you so much, Jack Whittle.
Well, folks, as you all must know by now, at the next half-Senate election, I'll be running for the Senate as an independent candidate for the Australian Beef Party. Now, I know that you came along here tonight to be entertained, and far be it for me to shove my beef politics down your throat. That's the last thing I'd want to do. I am first and foremost an entertainer.
As good as any disco machine,
yes, we. I am here to entertain, and by jingo, I'm going to entertain. However, every fair-minded member of the audience here tonight will agree with me that this country is being ruined by those communists up in Canberra.
Right, Slim, right, mate, right.
No,
Canoe.
Now, I don't want to involve myself in a mudslinging match with that upstart Collins Street farmer who pretends to be a prime minister or his brown tongue lackeys. That's the last thing I'd want. Calls himself a farmer. What would he know about scarifying or Patterson's curse control or crutching sheep? The only dags he ever removed were Gorton and Sneddon. Oh, no. I'm sorry. I won't drag myself down to his level. My fellow Australians, I've been all over this big, beautiful country
sure,
of ours.
It's a big, beautiful country, Dad.
Yes, Whit.
Full of big, beautiful people.
Yes, big, corpulent people, Whit. And I know wherever I travel, whether I be in the cities, in the country, I might be in the outback, I might be in the middle of nowhere, wherever I am, I will always find some silly bastard out there trying to make a quid. That's the spirit that made this country great. A is for Australia, the land that I love. B is for its beaches and those sunny blue skies up above. C is country music. It means so much to me. And D is for the diggers, our brave Australian and New Zealand boys who fought at Gallipoli. You know, I wasn't fortunate enough myself to fight at Gallipoli, but I did serve in the Second World War as a fighter pilot. I got smashed up pretty bad in the Battle of the Coral Sea when I landed on an enemy aircraft carrier. The Japs were torturing me when our boys torpedoed that carrier. About 3 weeks later, as I floated into Sydney Harbour, I was picked up by the Manly Ferry. General Douglas MacArthur and some of his boys were on board with some wonderful Australian girls. As they threw me back into the harbour, everyone was laughing and singing a new song.
Come on, Aussie, come on, come on. Come on, Aussie, come on.
L is for this land, so vast, so great, so free. M just stands for mate, and you know you're all like mates to me. G'day, pal, how you going? N means new Australians who helped this country grow into the great country she is today. My fellow Australians, our great country faces its gravest economic crisis since the Great Depression. Unemployment approaches the 500,000 mark. Inflation has been reduced, but only at the expense of real wages. Not only is the average Australian expected to shoulder an ever greater tax burden, but the price of beer and cigarettes has soared. Even the pension is taxed now. Are we to stand idly by while politicians and bureaucrats better their nest at our expense? No! While multinational corporations take millions of dollars out of this country? No! Who will save us? The Liberals? Huh? Labour? Ross Edwards? What this country needs is a meat marketing board.
Right, Slim, of course, mate.
We already have a wool board, an egg board, a wheat board.
Mum's got a bread board too,
How
Dad.
Can we have a rational meat marketing strategy if we don't have a meat marketing board?
Right, Slim,
now,
right, mate.
I have written to the Minister for Primary Industry outlining my proposals, which include the immediate establishment of a beef research station right here in Fitzroy to investigate the potential uses of beef. The beef-powered car, beef poolside furniture, and the beef CB radio, just three of my proposals.
Good on you, Slim. Good on you, mate.
I demand that soya bean
be declared a noxious weed.
It's about bloody time too, Slim. It's about bloody time.
And the reintroduction of the death penalty for anyone found guilty of the cultivation of soybean.
Hanging's too bloody good for them, Slim. Right, Acacia, right, love.
You cannot buy an honest pie these days. Wait there, have I been preaching politics again? Look, I know I shouldn't. I said I wouldn't at the start of the show. Let's get right on with the show.
One, two, three, four. A cowboy was dreaming of his one true love. The look of love was in her eyes. It even seemed as though she blew him a kiss. To him, that kiss was no surprise. A cowboy gets restless if he stays in one place. A powerful urge causes him to roam. But it gets mighty lonesome out on the range, and his heart will always lead him home, back to Miss Kitty, Miss Kitty, the sweetest gal in Tamworth City, twinkle in the sky. His sweetheart disappeared,
she did,
and turned into a stare as
the cowboy
opened up his eyes. You know, it's strange what can happen to you when you're out on a cattle drive. The hot sun beating down on your head, you can kind of drift off to sleep in the saddle. That's what this cowboy did. He started dreaming about the girl that he left back at home. Trouble is, he fell off his horse. And as the dream dissolved, there he was just lying on the ground, staring eye to eye with a young Hereford steer. That's when he realized he hated cattle droving. Much preferred to be back in the arms of his gal. Miss Kitty, Miss Kitty, the sweetest gal in Tamworth City, Miss Kitty.
Ladies and gentlemen, I've just received a very important telephone call from the Secretary of the Australian Beef Party, Murray Gray. Ladies and gentlemen, I have some very good news for us all. It appears that
The latest Gallup poll has come out, and my popularity rating is 14.837%, more popular than Malcolm Fraser. Oh, yes. Thank you. I love you. You're beautiful. Thank you so much.
Fabulous.
You can fool some of the people some of the time, Malcolm, and all of the people all of the time, but you can't fool the Australian public. You're too smart.
Right, Slim,
you know what's going on.
The people here tonight are 100% behind you, Slim.
When I am Prime Minister, I promise you, full unemployment.
Good on you, mate.
The best inflation in the world.
Fantastic, Slim.
Free contraception for pensioners.
That'll get your votes, mate.
A cow in every pot and pot in every cow.
Good on you, Slim.
Thank you. I knew I was born to rule. When they made me head prefect at Tamworth High School.
Right, Steve, right, mate, right.
Last night, I had a dream, a vision, which confirmed something I have known for a long time now. I am God. On the south side of Albury, stop me, cause the fruit fly don't give in. Got a 10-ton Kenny with 20 forward gears, 5,000 fruit flies and a load of rotten pears. Fruit fly inspector splattered on my bumper bar. I wouldn't harm a fruit fly, you know my desire. Truckload of pears, they are rotten to the core. Yeah, well, look out, buddy, I'm gonna bust across the Murray. Any ratbag politicians, you better move out in a hurry, cause I'm driving down from New South Wales first thing tomorrow morning. Rotten pears on Mal Fraser's front lawn. I'm good last time and I bring you good last in, yeah!
In keeping with the Whittle family's traditions of bringing the absolute pits in Australian entertainment, we are fortunate enough tonight to be able to present to you one of Australia's blues legends, blind boy Billy Polkinghorne.
Thank you.
Look out for the chair, Billy.
Always joking. This is me mate Brown Eye. Billy and Brown, we've been around together for a few years now giving people the blues. And we're coming here tonight to give you all the blues. Friends of mine down at the car factory, the tyre factory, said, Billy, you ought to be an entertainer. So here I am. And I'm going to do a song for you I wrote when I was coming down off a heavy relationship with a chick. It's called I Got a Rotten, Laid Out, No Good, Mean, Evil, Cheating, Hard-Headed Woman. And I normally play it with a slide, but I couldn't find my slide, so I brung a spanner in from work. But no, she'll be right. She'll... Beautiful. You know, I was inspired to write this song by a good friend of mine, fellow blind guitarist Mr. Jose Falacio. And it goes like this anyway. I just don't know what. Got a hard-headed woman. Yeah, I hit her with a lump before. She not only broke my heart, but she broke my piece of wood too. She's a mean mistreater. Yeah, she's always telling me lies. She's a mean mistreater. Yeah, and she keeps me locked up inside. Just to make sure I didn't wander, she went and poked at both my eyes. Yeah, that's why I'm Blind Boy Billy, man.
Woo! Blind Boy Billy Polkinghorne, ladies and gentlemen. Blind Boy Billy Polkinghorne and Brown Eye McGee. Fabulous, Billy, absolutely fabulous. Right, that was wonderful, son.
I'm sorry I was a bit late getting here tonight, Tony. I've lost my dog, you see. And I can't find him anywhere. His name's Biff. He's about this high, and he's got a little slot in the top of his head. So if you see him around, you know, pick him up for me, would you, please?
Billy poking. Watch out, Billy! Someone's thrown a glass! Just a little joke, Billy. Just a little joke, mate.
Look at this here, Tammy. Another young person has self-immolated.
Oh, oh no.
Oh, my God, Father, that's shocking. You're shocking. What does it mean?
It means that he set fire to himself, Tammy. That's what it means. And it was on a day of total fire ban. You know who's behind this, don't you, Tammy? It's these foreign religious soybean sects, Tammy. Cults.
Oh, not a cult.
The kids are systematically brainwashed. They fill them up with soya bean, then they take them out and set fire to them. How can they do it, Tammy? Just tell me. How can they do it?
I think they pour petrol over them, then they strike
them. The boys in the fire brigade have enough on their plate without having to deal with this sort of thing.
And what about the petrol shortage, Slim? That's what's really got me worried. It's a terrible...
Oh, that bothers me too, Tammy. And you know they all live in these communes, Tammy. And you know what goes on in those communes?
Yes, Slim. Sex.
It's a disgrace.
All the girls sleep with the swami. They have gangbangs every Sunday, Slim.
When I'm in Canberra, it will be banned.
Remember when we were young, Slim, we were just the same. Once Slim got the scent, there was no stopping him. Not that I ever wanted to.
Look, Tammy, I don't think anyone
remember
really
remember our honeymoon at the Buchan Cave, Slim?
Yes, Tammy, I remember
we were at it all the Buchan time.
Shut her up, Slim.
I taught Slim the Kama Sutra backwards. It was a very difficult position because Slim's legs used to go to sleep. I'll be finished in a minute, Slim. Then we'd get stuck and have to call the doctors in to pull us apart. Oh, love, they were a few times, weren't they, Slim?
Tammy, remember you're a politician's wife and there's certain things that you should not discuss in public.
My lips are sealed. Of course, these days, Slim's favourite position is on top of the fish tank. When we get on top of that tank, you ought to see those goldfish fly. They look beautiful.
Tammy, remember the election, Tammy.
Yes, it's a big one, isn't it?
Tammy, you're making it hard.
Oh, good, Slim.
Thank you, Tammy. Thank you. I think you've said enough. Thank you very, very much. There's the piano. Sit behind it.
Joe Whiskers and Go Cats. Come out with me, pussy, and we can dance on scraps. vitamins and minerals, A, B, C, D, E, and K. Throw away your mold, crumb pussy, let's go on a date. We ain't no pussycat and now. I'm Tommy and you're my gal. We ain't got nothing to lose except these tomcat blues.
Welcome to Tomcat, you can pick me up at 8. I'll be proud around the alley, scratching at the gate. I'm waiting for you, Tommy, don't you let me die. I've got on my big mittens, a genuine cat for guy.
Got what it takes to keep your pussy happy. No mess, no bother, even if you're fussy. I'm a feline fanatic, I'm bouncing for the vine. Don't you scratch me when we play like wine. We ain't no pussycat I know. I'm Tommy and you're my gal. We ain't got nothing to lose except these tomcat blues. Jump over my fence, I'd love to make you howl. Rub my fur the right way, give my catnip a punch. We can have a kitty litter, maybe two or a bunch. We ain't no pussycat I know. I'm Tommy and you're my gal. We ain't got nothing to lose except these tomcat blues.
Now the boring old fart's gone, I'm gonna blow the shit out of this. Hey, rock, riff. Now the boring old fart's gone, I'm gonna blow the shit out of this place, man. With 5 watts of raw power.
Yeah, we can lay a bit of heavy whittle on you now, mate. Cause disco sucks!
Right,
sir.
Baby, right.
I'm hot for some rock, baby.
Listen. We're doing the song that I taught you out in the bungalow before we come down.
Oh, beauty, yeah. Uncle Jack taught us how to play new and used wave, man.
Yeah, Uncle Jack taught us a lot of things.
Hey, no, now steady on.
Yeah, come on, Jack, you gotta let the girl have a bit of head sometime. I always told Slim we should do more things with the kids.
Come on, Mum. Let's get it on, eh?
Okay, son.
No, wait, no, this ain't punk rock. No, I call it wit rock. And I'm known as Whitrock Whittle, the rough cut king of rock and roll. I said the rough cut king, I'm the king, baby. King Whit. King Whit. Playing a rough cut, and I'll play it tough, man, because I'm so tough, I'm too tough to care. All right? Yeah. Can't end up and down here. I just lost the button off of my trousers. Hey, you wanted my pants to fall down?
Oh, no, yeah. Forget it, Whit.
All right.
There's nothing
roll
there.
Roll over, Kamal. We're going to play the banal.
I'm going to tell you about the pigs that run this country, man. Fraser is a crazy sailor, stand from the bridge, drop that SS Australia. He's mad, I stand in front of the mirror. He's mad, we better knock him out. The Germans should be down. Captain Fraser went and cut our rations. If we fight back, man, we got the best shit. I don't know if I can stand him anymore. Give me now, we don't know it for sure. He's mad, I stand in front of the mirror. He's mad. Way better knock him out. He's mad. He's mad. Don't give me the shits cause you shit me. Don't shit me cause you give me the shits. Well, Ronald McDonald, you better watch out. I'm gonna get a quarter pounder and shove it in your mouth. He's shit. I'm gonna make you eat your own shit.
play squash on Wednesdays and Saturdays with Alan. He thought he was fit until he got these pains in his chest whilst doing the tango hustle at the Star Ball with Liz, his wife. When zombies love, they're just in love with life. When zombies love, they're just in love with life. She's a beautiful person and a wonderful wife. Bob's brother Bob, he lives on the Gold Coast at Bob's Clone Clinic. He's my genial host. I'm cold night and day except when he's fishing. Life's a ball, now it's eternal. Wow. Who cares if all the women look just like Liz? They're beautiful people and wonderful wives. On Sundays we take them out on clone country drives. When zombies love, they're just in love with life. When zombies love, they're just in love with life. They're beautiful people and make dicky little wives.
Gentlemen, on behalf of myself, my beautiful wife Tammy, our daughter Acacia, our son Whit, and my brother Jack, my cousin Mr. Andy Bolgan, and the Flaming Stars, I'd like to say thank you and good night. I'm Slim Whittle, and
we're the Whittle family.
Thank you.
Number.
Thank you.
tune or any of the tunes you hear on tonight's show, you might care to buy a copy of Down Home Down Under, the Whittle Family's new album, out now on Birdship Records.
I'm proud to be Birdship Records' number one female recording artist.
I know that you'll enjoy Down Home Down Under. Why not join Slim, Tammy, Dad, Acacia, and yours truly, Jack Whittle, as we sing and play our way into your hearts with songs you'll listen to again and again. Recorded in the Whittle's own lounge room, you'll feel all the atmosphere of a family evening in front of a blazing log fire as the Whittles play our own brand of country and western music on Down Home Down Under, our new album out now on Birdship Records.
Records $5.98, cassette $6.98.
You'll wish you were there as we play Little Boy Lost, Farmyard Yodel, Pub with No Beer, Green Green Grass of Home, Pub with No Grass, or Take a Walk Down Memory Lane.
I got the Jack from McQueen. Supper time and the liver is greasy.
And many, many more on Down Home Down Under, the Whittle Family's new album out now on Birdship Records.
Of course, if you're feeling a bit peckish on the way home after the show, why not drop in at your favourite Whittle Family restaurant? Our burgers are 105% pure beef.
No soybean substitutes.
The kids will love them, and they might even get to meet Australia's favourite clown, Little Mick Whittle.
We got sirloin, we got pump, we got T-bone, we got chump chops at Whittle's, we got beef.
And don't forget, folks, what you don't eat today, you'll eat tomorrow. And here she is, ladies and gentlemen, the Nightingale of the North, my beautiful sister-in-law, Miss Tammy Whittle.
Thank you.
on my bumper bar.
Now that you've whipped yourselves up to a ladder of excitement, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to
up with this little number. Introduce a band, play electric guitar, and a slightly red light. On the bass guitar, Lindy Allen. On the drums, Gary Shawbait Adams. I'm Slim Whittle, and we're the Whittle Family. Thank you. Thank you.
Will you send me one of those? Shake my head. Get me out of town with $5. Never took a million of blue pins. Never drive a car when you're dead. Saturday's a festival. Oh, now Saturday's a day. Follow me to beauties on dry creek road. I got the red hand in my belly done so cold. Never trust a man in a blue print. Never drive a car when you're dead.